Thank you for tuning in to the Pointless Talks podcast. This episode is being brought to you as a part of the many things that Pointless creates. For our returning listeners, thank you so much for coming back. And if this is your first episode, welcome, get comfortable, and please keep an open mind. Welcome back, y'all. It's just me alone tonight, today, whenever you listen to this, because Twin is out. We will reconvene next week. But I couldn't let this week pass without touching on the one thing that was on my notepad this week, which you guys probably already guessed it, was Roe versus Wade being overturned by the U.S. Supreme Court last week. Yeah. For those of y'all who don't even know what Roe versus Wade is, by now you should probably know. You've probably seen it all over the internet already. But just in case you don't, Roe versus Wade was a landmark decision by this U.S. Supreme Court in which the court ruled that the constitutional rights of privacy regarding whether or not a woman is able to have an abortion was protected. So it generally protects a pregnant woman's liberty to choose to have an abortion. So under Roe versus Wade, if you felt like you had to get an abortion or you wanted to get an abortion, you had that right to do so. And currently, it's been overturned. So this U.S. Supreme Court is the law of the land. For those of you who don't live in America or who just don't know, y'all didn't pay attention in civics class or whatever. But it's basically the law of the land. The things that are outlined in the U.S. Supreme Court, like the legislature, the things that they pass, like the Constitution, things of that nature, it's basically, it applies to every state no matter what. Now, with this being overturned, it leaves the judgment, the ruling, the statute in the hands of each individual state. There are states currently who ain't with it at all already, even before this, which violated the Supreme Court standing in the past. But now, you know, they can vote and they can say, hey, you can't come to Texas if you want to have an abortion because that shit's illegal here or whatever state. There's a bunch of states that already are like, yeah, that's a dub. There are some that, you know, allow it under certain circumstances, you know, the ones that are against a woman's will or whatever the case is, quote unquote, even though if you can get pregnant against your will during consensual sex, but we'll talk about that later. So yes, so that's for anyone who's ever had like a legal class or any kind of conversation with anyone about politics or, you know, beliefs and things, some way, somehow abortion laws came up. And there are people who are either on the fence on one side or the other. And I just feel like if you don't want to get an abortion, don't get an abortion. Don't worry about what other people are doing with their bodies. But the thing that is getting me that a lot of people aren't even realizing is Roe versus Wade does not only protect a woman's choice to have an abortion, which is why we are here on Pointless Talks talking about Roe versus Wade right now. Yeah. Okay, so for those who didn't know, Roe versus Wade also ties into the 14th Amendment, which, you know, many people have taken for granted because it covers things like contraception, interracial marriage, and same-sex marriage. These things didn't, you know, exist prior to the Due Process Clause that was ratified in 1868, but in today's day, prior to this, all of those things were protected. And now the LGBT community, people who are open to dating other races, etc., are kind of in a frenzy because they might be next on a chopping block. You know what I'm saying? Especially with all this like pure white shit that's going on and they're trying to maintain the race or whatever the fuck. Like, you might not be able to go marry your interracial bae based on this, and it might be left up to states, and people are not realizing this, right? Also, same-sex marriage, that shit just became legal, and I say just because it's within the last 10 years, just became legal. Listen, if y'all didn't get married yet, on a run gummy case, if you can't still do it, yeah, because that might be up next. I feel like that, I don't know. I feel like interracial marriage, honestly, might like be attacked before same-sex marriage. Just for the simple fact of, you know, maintaining the race and that whole foolishness. But anyways, that's really all I came here to talk about because that shit sick my stomach. I went on Twitter the day it got, like, overturned or whatever. And we talked about this. Me and Twin talked about this. Dem Sugar, we talked about this on a couple episodes back when the information was leaked that it was even a conversation. And I was like, man, don't do this. Like, when I tell you my stomach, like, I literally felt nauseous for, like, the whole day. After I saw this, I started seeing it on Twitter. I was like, this is not what I think. Like, people were tweeting about it without actually saying it. And I was like, I know. This isn't about what I think it's about. Ain't no motherfucking way. Ain't no motherfucking way. Ain't no way. And sure enough, I get a text message from my bitch. And she's like, oh, yeah, they're overturned. And I'm like, what? Like, literally, like, I felt tears come to my eyes thinking about that. Because I'm like, bruh, how, like... Listen, y'all want to call this the land of the free and the great America and whatever, whatever. This shit can bundong for y'all make here. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm sick. Like, I'm legit sick. Like legit. Like, why not just let people live their lives? Like, why are you trying to put a law in place that governs how people live their private life? Like, 14th Amendment rights. Like, certain rights to privacy, like, should be upheld. In my opinion, because I feel like if you wake up one morning and you decide to say, you know what, me and my same-sex partner want to get married, we should be able to get married. Or if you wake up and you and your interracial partner, your other racial, whatever the hell partner, decide, you know, y'all want to get married, y'all should be able to get married. If you get pregnant, whether by choice or by accident, and decide that you no longer want to be pregnant, you should be able to do that. And one thing that I really hate about, like, doctors and, like, the business of, like, healthcare in America, I have heard from way too many women that they were unable to get their tubes tied because, one, they weren't married, or two, their spouse didn't agree to it. It's my bumba clot uterus. Oh, y'all gotta tell me that me can't tie for me tube them because somebody who is not me might want children out of me. What? And then now this. I can't decide to have an abortion because what? Because what? And I hate the argument of, oh, being careless, da da da. Listen, there are so many ways to get pregnant by accident. You can use a condom, you could be on birth control, and you can fucking pull out and still possibly get pregnant. The condom slip off or the condom bust are, you know what I'm saying? Like, so many different ways. And people are like, oh, well, just stop having sex then. Excuse me? Tell a man if you're going to get a vasectomy, okay? Because vasectomies are supposedly virtually painless and you can reverse it. Why not get... Actually, I shouldn't even say that because I saw a post yesterday that said vasectomies are on the rise. Them niggas don't want no babies neither. It's just, it's always been on the woman to get it and making sure, hey, it's your body. Figure out what you're going to do with it. Most times when heterosexual people are performing intercourse, it's usually on the woman. Like, it's like, oh, I ain't got no condoms. You're not on birth control? Like, what? Pull out the rubber. Like, you know what I'm saying? But anyways, I just, I need America to do better. I need the legal system to do better. I need all of it to do better because this is literally a war on, like, your freedom. It's not necessarily just a war on women. I mean, it is because at the end of the day, you're forcing women to have children, essentially. Y'all trying to get rid of Plan B. In some states, it's probably already gone. You know what I'm saying? Then y'all talking about ain't no baby formula on the shelves. Like... y'all really care about these kids? And for people who are talking about I don't believe in killing babies, da da da. Y'all realize that them kids are being born and dying in real life as children or being abused. Like, there's so much that happens to children that are not wanted that could be avoided if you allow the resources for safe abortions. Do y'all know that, like, abortions are medically, like, required for some, like, failed pregnancies? Like, you can save a mother's life simply by performing an abortion if the pregnancy didn't go right. Like, septic pregnancies, like, don't get me started. I'm sorry if I'm triggering anyone. I'm truly not intending to trigger anyone with this, but it's not just for people that are careless. And that's the part that y'all need to stop focusing on. And even if somebody is quote-unquote careless, it's their bomba clot body. Like, especially at the rate at which people are paying for abortions. Like, I heard them things cost hundreds of dollars. So if somebody want to drop a couple grand or however much money to go have a safe abortion, why not make it legal? It's a business at the end of the day, right? But no, you know what it is? It's more expensive to give birth than to have an abortion. That's where the money's at. What? Bringing babies into the world? Hell yeah. That's how they making the money. Y'all ever seen somebody's hospital bill after giving birth? Man, listen. I really want to know what the end game is. Something is brewing, and I know something is brewing. I feel it in my spirit. Something is brewing. I want to know what is happening. Like, what is going to happen? Why all of these things are like, it's like a domino effect. Like, one thing happened here, one thing happened there, one thing happened there. And I just want to know what the big picture is, because obviously I'm not seeing it yet, but something is going on. Like, why y'all want more children? Is it because the, what you call it, births have decreased over the years, like versus however many decades ago? The people are getting smarter. In this economy, who can afford to have a child? Listen, on this gas price, there's no baby formula. Y'all got people doing mass shootings every which way you turn. Anywhere you go, niggas is out here with guns shooting people. Why would you want to bring a child into this world? People out here trying to have soft life and travel and do this, that, and the next. Child care is expensive, baby, and y'all are not paying enough. Y'all think $15 an hour is going to support 1, 2, 3, 4 picnic? At this rate, people don't even want food stamps. Give me gas stamps, because that's where the money at. Like, the money is going to gas. You feel me? So, I mean, yeah, I'm really honestly just bummed out about the whole Roe versus Wade thing. And I want something to change. I want it to go back to what it was. I need better from this country. I need better for every upstanding citizen in this country. I can't manage, but that's really all I came here to talk about was Roe versus Wade. Y'all need to do y'all research. I didn't give y'all full 100% details on this. It's a quick little come and say what's up, just so we didn't, you know, blank on this week's episodes. But do your research. Y'all thinking this is just about abortion? Roe versus Wade does not only cover abortion. It covers so much more. And I'm pretty sure you know somebody who knows somebody who knows somebody who either had an abortion, wanted to have an abortion, or has an interracial spouse or a same-sex spouse or partner. So it affects literally, like, just about everybody who's not racist or, like, gay or, like, you know, homophobic. And, like, everybody, literally everybody. It affects everybody. So, yeah, make sure y'all check out all the other episodes. I should have done this in the beginning, but good guy of the week this week goes to my bitch, my best friend. I don't even need to say her name. I'm not even going to say her name because she knows who she is. And she's getting good gal of the week because she has steamrolled the decision for Miami Gardens Police Department to have their first ever LGBT representative fleet. What that means is, they currently, because of her pushing it, because she gay as hell, they got a couple vehicles wrapped with rainbow colors, etc. So that's a thing now moving forward. I know most people are going to be like, oh, but what are they doing for the community? Whatever, whatever. Baby steps, okay? And shout out to Reggie for being appointed as the LGBT liaison for Miami Gardens Police, Miami-Dade Police. Shout out to y'all, okay? Good gal of the week, my bitch. Shout out to you. And yeah, I really ain't got nothing else. Tune in on YouTube, subscribe to our channel, and check out the unboxings, the unmoldings. Follow me on social media. It's Pointless Talks on everything. And the fact that I still have to tell y'all that it's 3 S's, because I thought I didn't have to tell y'all no more, but y'all, I still have to tell y'all it's 3 S's. PointlessTalks. Type it in on Google and you'll find me, okay? So subscribe to us on all the social media platforms. Find us on your favorite streaming platform and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend. And you know what I'm saying? If you have any questions or anything, you can reach out to us on those social media platforms or you can email askpointless@gmail.com. Yeah, just like every other week. Everything else we do over here at Pointless Talks, whether you got here on purpose or by fate, thank you so, so much for tuning into this episode of Pointless Talks. On a walk, good, yeah? Bye.